Hey guys, Nick here. Let's check out how to play barre chords today. So, welcome back guys for another lesson. Thanks for joining me. I'm Nick Morrison and I'm from the Guitar Dojo. And if you're a first-time viewer, please make sure to hit that like, subscribe, and smash that bell notification button because it lets the algorithm know that my content is actually worthwhile. But today, we are talking about barre chords. Now, typically, a barre chord runs across all six strings and it looks something like this. And of course, I'm not plugged in today because this is more of a hand exercise rather than a we need to have really good recorded electric guitar sound. The biggest problem, I think, for most beginner guitar players, aside from the F chord, or the F chord as a bar, is just barre chords in general. So if you haven't yet, I have a video all about my best guitar hack to help you play any song ever. All I'm doing in that video is teaching the simple fact that across the top three strings, you have a minor chord that's spelled out. And then if you add one finger to the same form in front of that third string, you get a major chord. Now you can practice this anywhere on the neck. And of course the root of that chord form, this is an inverted chord, meaning normally a chord stacks root, third, fifth. The way that the strings are laid out, this is gonna actually play from bottom to top, third, fifth, root. Or 3-5-1, I guess if you wanna call it that. But minor chord, major chord. And that's really where I like to start my students with learning chords, because it's easy, you really only need strength on one finger, and then you need to add one more finger on top of it. And then boom, you've got that chord. And that simple form can be played all over the neck, and it's very, very easy. Now, if you want to play a four-string chord, you just need one more finger. And this is the cool part, again, about the way that the guitar is structured. So we're gonna play an A minor here, for example, okay? So this is the root, the fifth, the minor third, and then we're going to play our third finger, three frets up on the next string, and this reinforces the root. That's an A all over again. So those top four strings go, right? So root, minor third, fifth, root, octave. And that's a nice easy form that you can then move anywhere on the neck. Now you'll see my hand as I'm playing this minor chord, I shift my middle finger, instead of just kind of letting it hang and not do anything, I actually shift it a little bit and I use, you can see here, I reinforce my first finger with my third finger to help me make that chord. So let's do that one more time. Here, you can actually see what I'm doing. So I'll play the root, the minor third, the fifth, and you can see that that middle finger is kind of acting as a backstop or an extra reinforcement. Now what happens when we play major, because we want to put that finger down here, the interesting thing about the hand is that when the fingers are engaged in an activity together, like if you're actually doing this, they all kind of work in tandem, and so even if you're not pushing like this with the second finger onto the first, there still is strength there. So in this case, we're gonna play root, major third, fifth, octave. And that's it. Now what I usually do with my students when I'm teaching them sort of one-to-one is I get them to do the three chord triads first, or the three note triads first. So the minor, because it's the easiest to get your fingers on. Then the major, just those top three strings. Then we add the root again. Now, if we want to add one more string, and this is where it kind of gets fun, Again, we can be in any position, it doesn't matter, because the guitar is a transposing instrument. So what you do in one key or position, you can do in every other key or position. Okay? So let's take that. We're gonna do the D again, because what the heck, we're up near the top. So we're gonna take that root. And take the root. So we're playing here on the 4th string on the 12th fret, the 5th string on the 11th fret, and then we're playing 10 and 10 on the B and E. And that's our major chord. Now if we want to add one more string, we're actually going to just add our pinky. So we're going to replace our 3rd finger with our pinky finger, so 4th finger, and then the 3rd finger will actually go below it. And now we're playing a slightly inverted chord again here, so we're actually stacking 2 chords together, right? And that's the 5th again. There's the root, there's the 3rd, there's the 5th, there's the octave. And then again, to play minor, we just take that middle finger off. So you can see what we're doing is we're starting with 2, 3, adding 4, and then adding the 5th. And something that's interesting, if I go back to the 3, or the 4 notes, excuse me, what does that look like? It's an F. Right? So we've just learned how to make that pesky F chord all the way down to the bottom, but we're doing it up where the frets are a little closer together and it's a little easier to get under our fingers. And then of course the big stretch now, once you've got this all under your fingers, is stretching all of that across all 6 strings. And again, I always suggest starting up a little higher because the frets are closer together and it's just a little easier to make everything sound good. Whereas if we're playing an F all the way down here, especially if you're on acoustic, it's very hard to practice. If you have it available, I always suggest playing full 6 string bar chords with an electric guitar first, because the strings are thinner, the neck is smaller, it's easier to get your hands on it, and you can build up some hand strength first on that electric. And then once you have the hand strength built up a little bit in there, it'll be much easier to make the shift over to an acoustic based, or like in this case a hollow body guitar or jazz guitar, something like that, jazz box we usually call them. But that's it. That's really my best tip for you to play bar chords. It's really the easiest. Start with the 2, start with the 3, right? 1, 2, 3, right? So root, 5th, root, 5th, major 3rd, root, lower 5th, lower 5th, and then octave. And you can do all 6. And again, this never changes. The only note that changes when you're doing this form to make the minor is to remove that. And then again, you can see I throw my 2nd finger just kind of on my 1st. And then away you go. And you can play with this form now, right? So those last 2 are 7th chords, but we'll get into that in another lesson. So thanks again, guys, for tuning in today for my brief, very quick tutorial on bar chords. I hope you got something out of it. If you've used this technique before, or if you like it, or if you don't like it, leave me a message down below. Let me know if it helped you, or if there's maybe a different technique that you have for learning or for teaching bar chords. I'd be very interested to hear it, because I think, like I said at the beginning, I think bar chords are probably one of the most difficult things physically for new guitar players to learn. So again, don't forget to come check out my guitar community at facebook.com/groups/theguitardojo. You can sign up for my email list and get your free copy of Essential Chords and Scales for Guitar at my website, guitardojo.ca. And of course, link down below to buy my book, Guitar Fretboard Memory Magic from Amazon. Thank you so much for stopping in and spending some time with me today, guys. I've been here. You've been wonderful. Keep strumming, and we'll see you next week.